My story with Contact Family is setting up the organisation in the first place, but this was because I met families who had children with special needs at home who desperately needed the contact with one another and to meet and support each other and find information. They were really lost in the local communities.
I first remember Contact Family from the 1980s. I was a social worker working with disabled children in London, and I think at that stage we were just beginning to understand the importance of parents talking with parents and looking around for practice that did that and saw that and was part of that.
My story with Contact a Family goes back 30 years because I'm a father and my daughter is a young disabled woman, and I'll never forget what it was like as a young dad growing up with a child that was disabled and how different that felt from everything that I'd expected.
And I was a health visitor in the end of the 80s, and I used to use Contact a Family. There were new apps at the time, signposting families towards them and their directory of different kinds of children's special needs, and I found them extremely helpful then. Now I have a son with autism and epilepsy, they're much more relevant to me.
It started back in 2001 when I joined the National Autistic Society as a campaigner, and I worked very closely with Contact a Family from the beginning on issues affecting disabled children, children with autism. Then the story got better when I got to join the Every Disabled Child Matters campaign and worked extremely closely with Francine and the team at Contact a Family. And then in more recent years I've been a barrister and working again closely with the campaigns team and also doing lots of talks and events and training on the law for parent carers.
Contact a Family introduced me to parent carer participation and has enabled me to put all my skills and knowledge as a parent carer to work to change the world and to make a difference.
As a manager with the Family Fund, I often direct families to the organisation for advice and information. I also work collaboratively with Contact a Family within For Scotland's Disabled Children Coalition.
We had to set up Contact Line, the helpline, to get to more families and also to families who had more rare conditions. So it all grew very rapidly but naturally, and it's really nice that I'm still in touch with those original parents who are still grateful for the help we gave.
The passion I see from the organisation is evident in every person I speak to.
One of the reasons that I've spent all of my career working with families of disabled children is because of the people around me, the passionate nature of people who want justice, who want change, who want to make a difference, and Contact a Family is at the heart of that.
The most important word that I'd associate with Contact a Family is strengthening.
Inspiring.
And caring.
We help provide them with information and support that makes them stronger families.
Brilliance is the quality of the work. The information resources are always first class. The research that was done on DLA Takeaway might really be the difference between winning and losing a case in the Supreme Court.
I'm looking forward to the next chapter of Contact a Family because they have a wealth of knowledge and understanding in relation to disabled children and work with others to ensure that disabled children and their families have improved opportunities and can realise their rights.
For families like me, they provide much needed help and support, training, and they put events on which are relevant to me and my life and my son's life.
I think we're going to be needed more than ever.
I think the last 5 years have been difficult. I think families have been facing real challenges in terms of benefits, in terms of cuts in local services.
It's an incredibly difficult time for families, and your research has shown that more clearly than anyone's, how much austerity is affecting disabled children and their parents and loved ones, and we need to work together to challenge that.
Under the next government, there's every chance that children's services and welfare benefits in particular could be subjected to even bigger cuts, and our families are going to need Contact a Family.
Building and embedding right the way through is that partnership working and continue to work in co-production.
I think we make a powerful duo and I'm looking forward to that continuing.
It can't be done without, we need to be together.
If you didn't exist as an organisation, we just have to invent you. It's essential that there's a charity that's there, that's focusing on families of disabled children and bringing families together to fight for change.